Hi all, thank you so much for joining me on this online tutorial. I'm Savitri from All Things Beautiful. I'll be showing you how to make a simple and beautiful decoupage name board. The materials you will need are MDF plank, gesso, flat brush, napkin, glue, stencils, a plastic sheet, acrylic paints and varnish. Don't worry, I'll be taking you through all these materials step by step, and I'll also give you links to where you can buy them. So let's start. This is the MDF plank that I have chosen. It's a 7 inch by 14 inch plank. So first I will prime this plank. You can either use a gesso, which is a primer, or any acrylic, white acrylic paint. This is a very important step because the decoupage napkin is a very transparent paper. So if your base is white or any light color, the design shows through very bright. Please make sure this step is very important. So make sure that you paint the base white, or to match with your napkin, it could be a very light color. So let's just finish this base painting. Maybe one or two coats would do. You need to make sure you give it a very smooth coat of paint, and then let it dry completely. I'll be giving you loads of tips and techniques to do decoupage in a very easy way. So please, if you might want to make a note of it. So this is the decoupage napkin that I've chosen. I wanted something really bright and sunny, so these yellow flowers are very apt for it. So I'm just trying to see how I can place the design. You can choose any design you want. So before you start gluing them down, you can just put it on the plank and see where you want the designs to be, how you want to place them. And then once you're happy with the placement of the design, then you can go ahead and fussy cut them. To fussy cut, what you do is just dip a thin brush in water and then run it over the tissue, over the design, wherever you want it, and then just cut it off or peel it off. It will come off easily. Be careful when you're doing this. You don't want to soak the napkin with a lot of water. So just take a thin brush and dip it in little bit water. Just the tip, you dip it in water and just run it through the design. So I wanted to put those birds on top and not at the bottom, because I am going to continue this plants little above the board also. So I am going to put the other part of the design with the flowers and leaves on top of this. So I cut off the birds, and I am trying to see now how to place this other bit of paper over this design so that it gives a smooth finish. It's like a continuous design. So if you are doing the same thing with your paper, if you are having a design where you have to like cut and place them, make sure it's symmetric. Make sure it's not very obviously out of place. So that's the reason. First, before gluing it down, place the designs and see how it fits, and then you can glue down. So I just cut a small part of the flower there, and you know, it fits right in that space, and then it also looks like a continuous design. So I'll go ahead and do this, maybe cut different pieces and portions of the design and place them wherever I want it and see how that looks. Make sure you rip off the ends. We don't want any straight lines of the paper to be seen on the plank when we decoupage. Because when you rip off the ends, the any straight lines or fuzzy cut, the way it's called, it'll blend very well. It'll look like a print on the wood. It won't look like we have stuck some paper. So make sure if there are any straight ends, and if they're coming in the middle of the plank, make sure you fuzzy cut them. If they are at the end, it's okay. And now we have cut all our pieces. I just wanted to do some painting over the base. So if you actually see, the napkin has a very light print as a background. So I thought I would just do the same background in some stencils for the board as well. See this actually gives a very good look on the final finish, because like I said before also, the napkins are very, very transparent. So when you have some design at the bottom, it will show through the napkins when we decoupage it, and then it looks really, really beautiful. So I have chosen a similar print like the one on the napkin, these curly patterns. I have a stencil like that. So what I will be doing is, I chose a similar color also, whatever is there on the napkin. It's kind of a beige color, like a cream color. So I am going to stencil this design on the whole board. What happens is, when we stick the napkin over this design, wherever there is no print on the napkin, the this design shows through and it looks very, very pretty. So that's what I'm doing. And then the tip on stencils, because a lot of people have a problem using stencils. Stencils are very, very easy to use, and they give such a good effect on any project that you do. So the main tip is, never ever take too much paint on your brush, stencil brush. Another one is, when I say brush, you can either use a sponge or you can use a stencil brush like I just showed you. So always take very, very little bit of paint, and you dab the excess on a tissue or on a cloth. You only want very little paint on your brush. And then when you paint it on the stencils, you just do a dab up and down motion, or you can just do a circular motion. And this way the design comes out really crisp and nice. So the important thing is, never take too much paint on the brush. It has to be just enough for the color to come out, for the color and the design to come out very crisp. Here, the stencil is not big enough to cover the whole board. So I am keeping the stencil on the side. So when you do that, make sure again you continue the design. Because if you don't, if you just randomly put the stencil wherever and do the design, it will not look nice. So make sure you see where you're keeping the stencil, and the design comes out in a continuous way. Stenciling gives a very, very good and extra effect to your project. It makes the whole project come alive in many ways. So if any of you are interested in learning more about stenciling, you can ping me. I can do a tutorial just on stenciling, because there are so many things that you can do with stenciling, different techniques that you can learn with stenciling. I try and stencil on all my projects. Like I said, it gives a very beautiful breezy effect, so I really like it. So that's done. The whole plank is stenciled, so leave it to dry. Another very, very important step when you use stencil is to clean them immediately. I use very cheap quality baby wet wipes. You can do the same. So immediately after using the stencils, I rub the stencil with these baby wipes. These baby wipes have some soap, so you know it will help in wetting or moistening the paint, and it will come off easily. So once you have done this as a first step, then you can later soak them in some soapy water and wash them clean. This is a very important step again, because what happens is if you don't wash the stencils, they will start, you know, the paint will start drying on it and piling up, and you'll have a very thick effect layer of paint on it. So, you know, wash your stencils thoroughly immediately. So now we're ready to decoupage. So we have all the pieces ready. Now the next step is to remove the back ply. All the decoupage napkins, or even your normal kitchen napkins, have layers of paper, and these are called ply. So some of them have two layers, some of them have three layers, so they are called two ply napkins or three ply napkins. So when we decoupage, we only need the top layer where the design is. We don't want the other two or one layer back plain white. So make sure you remove all those layers. What is to be left is only the thin transparent design layer on top is what we want. The remaining, actually below the top layer, the second layer of white napkin, if you actually see, will have the imprint of the design. So you have to make sure you remove all those layers until you have that imprint also out. We only need the top transparent layer to decoupage. So now you will understand why I insisted, you know, that your base needs to be primed or painted in white, because of this. If you actually see, the napkin is very, very, very transparent. So whatever color you paint on your base, that will show through the napkin. So whatever design your napkin is, whether it's white or cream or blue or black, in decoupage technique, you always paint the base in white or maybe cream or like very, very, very light shades. And also, since it's see-through, since it's very transparent, the design that we the stencils that we did underneath is going to show through and fill up those white gaps and look really beautiful. Now on to decoupage. Now that you know where to place your napkins and glue them down, it's easy. So I always work in sections while gluing down the paper, because it's easy to work with smaller sections of paper, and you also get a wrinkle-free finish. Because in decoupage, if you get wrinkles, the finish doesn't look really nice. So it's very, very important that you don't have any bubbles or any wrinkles. You can use Mod Podge, you can use Fevicryl, you know, decoupage glue, or any other decoupage glue. Or if you're a starter, you can mix some water and normal Fevicol and use that also. It has different it's slightly different than using a decoupage glue. Or you can also use these camel and acrylic matte medium and gel medium. They are just glue, but they are not sealant as Mod Podge. But you can, these are cheaper options to Mod Podge, because Mod Podge is a little expensive. So you can use these to just glue down the napkin. So like I said, you work in sections. Just take a strip of the base, put some glue, not too much, not too less, just enough for the paper to stick on. Because if you put too much glue, your paper, since it's very thin and flimsy, it's going to tear off. So make sure you just put the right amount. And if there's very little or if there is no glue in some areas, the paper will bubble up. So please make sure that you apply glue all over the area, not leaving any space. If you leave any space when we glue down, all the places where there's glue will stick, and the place where there's no glue will bubble up, and then it's really difficult to take out the bubble and give it a good finish. So the another tip to getting a wrinkle-free result is not to rub with your hand, but to use a plastic sheet. You can use any plastic sheet, your old covers or some sheet or anything. So once you apply the glue and put your paper on, don't press it down, just put the plastic sheet on top and then press it down. And you always move outwards. When you're pressing down, you always move outwards. So what this does is it will remove any bubble or any wrinkle out of the way or towards the outside. So this is a very, very easy and foolproof technique to get a wrinkle-free finish. Always use a plastic sheet on top. Do not rub with your fingers or hands. Use the plastic sheet. Take a cloth or like just scrunch paper nap, scrunch some tissues in your hand and just rub it over the napkin in an outward direction. Now I am going ahead and just gluing down the rest of the paper. Like I said, you try and work in sections so you get a good finish. When you're folding and working in sections, make sure the where you fold, you put glue, because if you're going to leave that line, then it's going to bubble up. So you put the plastic sheet on top and just gently press it down, not giving too much pressure, but gently press it down outwards. You can see how beautifully it is stuck to the wood. It doesn't look like a paper stuck, but it looks like a print. And if you actually also see, you can see the design, the stencil that we did, you can see it underneath through the napkin. It looks really, really nice. So go ahead and glue the other pieces of paper as well, like however I placed earlier. So I will go ahead and glue all of them in the same manner. Apply the glue, just enough glue, and paste them down.
Thank you.
I'm gluing down the birds also now, so it looks nice. There are creepers from underneath and then there are birds on top. So I cut 2-3 pieces of these birds, so I'm just placing them wherever I want and gluing them down. So this is how it looks once I have glued everything down. So I will go ahead and sand those extra paper that's hanging out. See, this is like really beautiful. We still have to finish this because there is some continuity that we have to do with the creepers at the bottom. So yeah, we'll do that. But before that, like I said, once you finish gluing down, you should always seal the project. The Mod Podge, the decoupage glue, helps in sealing the project. It's not just a glue, but it's also a sealant. When I say sealant, what happens is over a period of time, your deco piece doesn't get yellowish, and also it is waterproof. So before you go ahead and paint over this or paint the sides or do whatever kind of painting, I strongly recommend that you put a thick coat of decoupage glue on your work. So be generous and apply a thick coat of decoupage glue and let it dry. So now we will finish these stems that you see here. They're all cut off because we attached two parts of the decoupage napkin. So I'll take a matching color, some two shades of green, and try and give some continuity in the design. The top part still looks a little plain to me, so I decided to put some small cute butterflies from this decoupage napkin. Yeah, I just cut some butterflies, removed the back plies and layers, and I'm going to just stick them randomly wherever I feel there's too much space. Once you glue this down, then just give, like I said, a top layer of decoupage glue again and seal it. Now we'll move on to pasting the name that you want on the board, or a welcome sign, or anything that you want. These are MDF alphabets, MDF cutouts. You get them in all stores that sell decoupage products or MDF products. So I chose to paint them in black because black will stand out on the board. The background is a very light design, so I chose black. Paint all the alphabets in black and let them dry before we stick these on the board. We'll first paint them in whatever color we want, and then we will varnish them. It's enough if you paint one side. You don't need to paint both the sides because we're anyway going to stick them on the board. So just paint one side of the alphabets. I'm applying varnish to these alphabets now. I have used the Aquadar PU exterior varnish here. It's from Asian Paints. It's a water-based varnish. The box, the 1 liter box, is a little on the expensive side, but then it comes a long way. I'll give all these details in my description, or you know, as a separate document. So varnish them. Make sure you just apply like a thin layer on it. Don't put too much, because if there is a blob, it will just dry like plastic. You don't want that. So apply a thin coat of varnish on all the alphabets and let them dry overnight. It has to be dry before we stick it to the board. We can paste these alphabets on the board. Before pasting again, what I will do is I will apply a coat of varnish all over the board. This is again to protect the protect your product or whatever you created now, and make it waterproof. So before I stick anything on, and also before I paint the sides and the back, I put a good coat of varnish all over my base. Now the varnish is dried, let them dry overnight, don't just leave it for 1 hour, let them dry overnight. Now I will paint the back. I usually use some brown colors to paint at the back, but it's up to you, you can paint whatever color you want to. So it doesn't really matter what color you paint, but I like to give it a wood finish, so I mostly paint the back and the sides with a shade of brown. I'll go ahead and paint the sides here now. So if you actually see, when you paint the sides, the paint might come off on the top. So you don't need to panic, because since we've already varnished, it'll easily come off. Just take a damp cloth or a damp tissue and just wipe it off and it'll easily come off. So that is another main reason why we varnish before we do any painting on the board. Actually, if you see, there's some paint that's come off on the board, but then you just have to wipe it with a damp cloth and it comes off clean. So it's really, really important that you protect the work that you have done with a coat of varnish. We are done. You can see a nice sheen on the board. Similarly, varnish your backside as well. You can give a couple of coats on the board, but please wait before giving those coats. You don't do it immediately. Each coat you should leave at least 2 days in between, so it can dry and cure well. Now that the board is varnished, the backs are painted, the sides are painted, as a final step we will stick our we will glue our alphabets down, or the names down. Like I always say, first place them and see if you're happy with the placement. Make sure they are the gaps in between the alphabets are equal. Place them and then lift one by one and glue it down. And to glue it down, you can use this glue called E6000 or any other industrial strong bond like Fevi Bond or Fevi Quick or any of those glues. Actually, even the Fevi Call is good enough to glue down the alphabets here. So, yeah, just place them wherever you want. Since these names are really long, I place them vertically, vertical downwards. You can place them across, horizontally, or whichever way you want. The biggest thing about this decoupage art is there is no right or wrong. the design you choose, the colors you choose, the way you paste them, the stencils that you do on them, or any creativity that you do on your projects are your creativity. You don't have to worry about whether it's right or wrong. Whatever you do is your imagination and your creativity and your art. So go ahead and play with this technique. It's something that will make you want to recycle anything around the house. If you don't have a MDF board, it's absolutely fine. If you have something in plastic, if you have, like, for example, even your kids' exam board, you can use that as well. You can do it on any surface, on any base, metal, plastic, glass, melamine, anything. So do try it out. It's a very addictive art, and you'll be amazed at the way you can turn some mundane, normal things around your house into beautiful pieces of art. Here I'm using a silicone gel to glue down. It's a very thick gel, and it's quite it's an industrial strong gel. You can just put like few drops around the alphabet and then glue it down. My daughter is helping here to make sure everything is straight and not crooked. I'm just removing any extra glue that's dried around the alphabets. See, another reason we varnished the alphabets first before gluing down is because if we apply varnish, the varnish will go in between the alphabets wherever there's gap, and it will dry like a plastic. So we want to avoid that. Now finally we will varnish the back of the board as well. This is also an important step because you don't want to leave it as a MDF. If you do that, you can't wipe them if there's any dust. So varnish both the sides, so in case there's any dust, you can always wipe it with a damp cloth. Make sure you varnish the sides as well, and you can give a couple of coats the front side of the board. This completes our work on the board. We're all done, and we have a simple, beautiful decoupage name board ready, and it's handmade, and that's the most important thing. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please do follow me on Instagram and Facebook, and subscribe to my YouTube channel for loads of such videos. Thank you so much, and happy crafting. Bye bye.